Hey, hey, what's going on, people? It is Deltre. Welcome back to some more... I almost said Fire Emblem. No, not technically Fire Emblem. TearRing Saga. So in the last part, we took on Ernst and probably the most difficult map this game has presented so far. But we did alright, and we even recruited for ourselves a nice Iron Shield. So, with that being said, we're gonna go on and take on Julius, who is... Oh my god, he's so fucking powerful! I don't even know how we're gonna beat him, but we're gonna do our very best. Apparently in this one, they started giving skills to generics, which is really cool. I kind of wish they would have done more of that, to be honest with you. Makes it more interesting in my mind. So I'm going to see what we can see. Anything special? Nope, you're normal. You're normal. This can't be everybody. I mean, look at how big this map is. Based on the unit list, I thought this was going to be much smaller. So there's something that I'm not seeing here. What about you? Nope, nothing. Just an arrow spot. Theodora, do I have to kill her? She doesn't seem like a bad person. But neither did Julius, though, I guess. Nobody here really seems like a bad person, you know? Ah, of course, Physic Asshole. As is tradition. Corman. Oh, this guy has... Oh, he has Urbanite, so he can move further. Okay, okay. This guy as well. He has Urbanite, so these guys can move a little bit further than I would normally expect. What about you? Yeah, I don't give movement to the guy locked in 3 move. Don't mind me. Alright, who am I gonna bring, anyways? Obviously not the Iron Shield, although I'll take it off of him. I don't even know why Neron was deselected. Couldn't tell you. Alright, let's give this a try. Okay, that didn't seem like all my units at all. I have made some kind of mistake.
Have you informed the soldiers yet?
Yes, Your Highness. They were extremely disappointed, but I persuaded them to follow your wishes. There is still a small contingent of soldiers in the city, but they should be returning to the barracks soon.
I don't want them to get involved. Most of them are injured and recovering.
With Ernst gone, we haven't got the manpower to hold off the Reaver in advance.
I made it clear to the stragglers, Your Highness, that Your Highness wants them to make it out alive.
Oh man, we're off to a great start.
I've got one more request for you, Theodora. Will you hear me out?
Of course, Your Highness.
Return to Canaan and get a grasp of the situation there. I haven't heard a single piece of news, and I'm worried about my lord brother, and about Sine's campaign.
Yes, Your Highness, but won't you come with me? You said it yourself, the Reavens have come too far for us now to stop them.
Why are you staying behind?
You know better than to worry about me, do you see my stats? You should be worried for them. I'm gonna be fine, Theodora.
Yes, I'm sure, but still.
Rudin's messenger said that if we surrender the palace, he won't pursue our retreat.
Once the remaining soldiers are prepared, I'm going to withdraw to Nozeria.
Is that the truth, Your Highness? Can I believe your words?
Don't make me repeat myself.
Your job is to find out what's going on in Canaan, and then report back to me.
Don't think about anything else.
I understand, Your Highness. Please wait for me at Nozeria. I will return to you without fail.
No, he's dead. He's dead. So, like, if I waited long enough, would he just leave? Or was he just... bullshitting. I can't tell.
It's so quiet. I don't hear any soldiers around.
They may be lying in wait to ambush. We can't be careless.
I'd hope to avoid fighting in the city. I didn't want to involve the citizens.
My lord, our messenger just reported back. Prince Julius refuses to surrender the castle. We'll have to take it by force.
Julius, why won't you understand?
He is the Camus in the game. Now, where's the other half of my units? Over here? Yeah, over here. Not sure why there's even a door here. Well, I don't even know why they bothered, man. Okay, so this doesn't look very bad at all. I am kind of curious, like, what the deal is with this map. It doesn't seem like it's very difficult. There's honestly not a whole lot going on. These guys aren't particularly stronger than the average bear. Although, like, it's kind of interesting that these guys would have, like, movement skills. I was kind of expecting a little more, though, I'm not gonna lie. Let's do it like this instead. Because that way, I can throw our boy right out into the middle of everything, and everything will die. It's good to have Neron back. And I can do the same thing on this side, but with San. Make sure we have this short spear web, obviously. I guess the biggest trick here is going to be hitting all these houses and seeing what kind of events there might be. Oh, I forgot to transform. That's fine. That's fine. I can transform into Frau just the same. She is also a death machine, so I'm not really worried. This gives me flight anyways. Yeah, oh, he doesn't have... Yeah, he has, like, no mastery. And that's a little bit annoying, but there's nothing you can really do. Don't think it's gonna matter. Can Mel hit this house? She totally can. What's in here? So, you're the ones calling yourself the champions of Utona, huh? Well, I don't care who you... I don't care why you're here. Just try not to cause us any trouble. It doesn't matter to me who... Oh my god. It doesn't matter to me whether you win or the Empire wins. It won't change a thing. What? Were you expecting me to give you something? This isn't a charity, bub. Now hurry up and get out. Oh, damn. She went there. Broke the fourth wall and everything. Come on, Gabe. Damn, I was expecting her to give me something, though. Now there's a subversion of a trope. This is... I'm not seeing it with this one, guys. I'm just not seeing the challenge here. The last one was pretty clear that it was going to kick you in the nuts right from the word go, but here it's just... I'm not seeing it. Vega runs in. Armor slays this guy. Oh, I took it off. What's wrong with me? He used a steel blade at any rate. He's not going to get doubled or anything crazy. Yeah, I just don't see it. The hardest part is going to be getting rooted into the throne in an amount of time that doesn't make me lose my mind. That should be everyone. Yep. Okay, so what's going on? Reinforcements or something? Well, there shouldn't be reinforcements, right? No soul. No Draco. No crit. No fun. Good try, though. Good try. So Neron blows him away. Gets another level up. Defense again. Neron is just all around too good. San's gonna eat a hit, but it doesn't really matter. Doesn't matter at all. That other guy, he didn't want any of this. Okay, here we go. What's happening now? Alright, you lot. We're withdrawing to Nolzaria. That's an order from Prince Julius. Sir, is the prince not coming with us? There have been rumors that he's going to remain alone in the castle. Is that true? We're not supposed to talk about this, but yes, that's his intention. But don't worry, all of his veteran soldiers will be staying with him. Those are his veteran soldiers? Oh my god, Julius, no! All the veteran soldiers are exhausted from their last battle. He can't send us away now. Okay, so that... Well, at least they try to justify why they're so weak. I guess they're supposed to be tired. We need to stay and help out. You have to survive. Live and serve the motherland. If you understand His Highness's feelings, then don't die in vain in a place like this. And just let the prince die in vain. I can't do that. I'm staying right here. Everyone else feels the same way. You fool. But I can't say I don't feel the same. You make me proud, men. May the gods forgive us, we who started this fight. Ah, so they're gonna start. Oh, yep, they're reinforcing already. Oh, yeah. So these guys. I assume this was the... one of the guys talking. Oh, no. Oh, geez. No, you guys should retreat. You should definitely retreat. Vega's on a warpath. Oh, god. This is gonna be really embarrassing. Oh, if that's the best they've got. I mean, who am I to judge, really? Luck. Magic. There we go. He really desperately needs magic. You know, I could almost just throw Vega right in the middle of everything. I'll bet he would come out on top. He did decide to become my best general. I'll probably kill the Levin Sword guy because he can actually deal damage. Oh, no, he can't. What am I saying? He has no magic at all. Wow. Wow, dude. You make the Levin Sword look like a bad weapon. How does that even work? It doesn't make sense to me at all. I'm gonna chill right there. Hopefully Julius doesn't move. If he does, then I have erred greatly. But it wouldn't make sense for him to move. If he does, though, this is gonna become a lot more interesting. I'll give you that. Now, who do I want to kill this guy with? It's always a good sign when I'm not really worried about winning or losing the battle. I just want to know who I should get my kills to. I guess San is as good of a choice as anybody else. What's in this house? Give me something. Don't rob me like that last chick. What are you supposed to be? The champions of Utona? Never heard of them.
I'll thank you to not disgrace this upstanding capital of Reeve with your trifling squabbles. The fact that rebels like you even call yourself Reavens is an embarrassment to this city. The Imperial Army may be disgusting, but so are you. You barbarians would do well to kill each other off.
I'm getting the feeling we don't have exactly the biggest fan base in this town. Jeez. Is there anybody here who doesn't want us dead? Oh my gosh, get one shot. Get one shot, kid. What a scrub. Hold on, is there anybody here who doesn't hate us? I'm genuinely curious now. But I should also keep in mind, how am I gonna kill Julius? Let me do some maths real quick. He has 19 speed. And a magic shield too. God damn, dude. I actually don't know how I'm gonna deal with that. Alright, back to the haters, I guess. What do you have to say?
Finally, you showed up. I've been waiting for you guys.
Oh, finally! Jeez, the recognition we deserve.
See this lovely shield? With this in hand, even Julius' attack would be nothing but mosquito bites to you. It's beyond priceless. But for you, I'd be willing to part with it for 10,000 G.
I don't have 10,000 G.
Why, you don't have the money?
Poor people have no business here. Alright, so when he's subjugating you and your people, let me know how you feel about that. Fucking asshole. Seriously, I don't understand why people aren't more willing to help the liberating army. I understand that some of these guys don't like us, but it's in every game. It's like you're going out to fight for not only your life, but theirs as well, and they still want to charge you. Fucking cheapskates.
Welcome to the gladiators. You want to make a big dream? I can't also save a life?
No, fuck gladiator whatever. Yeah, that's what it's called, gladiator. I don't care about that. I don't care about that at all. Never have, never will. I think San should be good to blow this guy back. Yeah, then I can visit her if she takes a hit. She probably will. Yeah, the steel lance is basically useless, so I might as well. Ow, that hurts a lot. Now I get the Luna. I don't even know that it would matter, though. He has, like, no defense, I'm sure. Oh, so I'm so good. Okay, what's in this house? More haters, probably.
Who are you people? You think you can just waltz in into my house? This is why I hate nobles. You all think the law doesn't apply to you.
Oh, he looked like an... I thought he was the fancy guy, so he's... He just hates nobles, I guess.
Get out of my house now, and never come back.
Okay, well. Shit, man. I don't even feel like we're the good guys anymore. Oh, Vega, Vega, Vega. Honestly, these guys can't even scratch him except for the boss. Yeah, he has so much defense, he's actually totally untouchable. So with that in mind, I'll just stand him right there and everything should die. Alright. I don't even want to try talking to these guys anymore. They hurt my feelings, man. They hurt my feelings. Oh, didn't really place her very well. Please don't move, Julius. Please don't move, Julius. Please don't move, Julius. Don't move. I can't imagine that he would. That'd be so ridiculous. Yeah, he's not even having it. He's like, yeah. I'm a little bit smarter than that. So are they just beelining for Rudin, or what are they doing? What's the deal? Just must be some kind of self-preservation instinct. Hey! More reinforcements. Oh, now what's going on at the arena?
Hey guys, the Imperial Army has been having a rough time against the Liberation Army.
Don't go ahead of yourself. The battle's still far from decided. Just hear me out.
Why don't we use this as an opportunity to throw our weight around? You want to support the Empire?
I'm not doing that. You couldn't pay me to side with them.
Not the Empire, you idiots, the other side. Those Imperials are all cowards.
Rudin's army is obviously going to win. So if we help them out, I'm sure we'll get a handsome reward. We might even be made knights.
Hey, that's not a bad idea. Alright, let's do it.
Okay, it's decided. Everyone, get geared up for battle. Don't let a single one of those Imperial bozos leave with their life.
So now we get a bunch of greenies, huh? Well, it's interesting story-wise, but I'm sure they'll be dead by the time they make their way over there.
Those damn gladiators. How dare they attack our retreat? I'll deal with them myself.
Tell the other soldiers to continue making their way along the line of retreat.
Yes, Your Highness.
To think that I'd have to taint this holy spear with the blood of mere bandits.
Now he's gonna move! Absolutely! Eugene, who are those warriors?
Gladiators from the local arena, it seems. They're attacking the Canaanites.
Do you think they're trying to show us their support?
Maybe, though not for the reason you think. Gladiators kill for sport, money, and fame. They wouldn't just suddenly start fighting for the sake of justice. They're in it for the reward.
So they're hoping I'll repay them for their troubles, is that it?
That, and there's always valuables to be scavenged off dead soldiers. To put it bluntly, they're just hungry hyenas taking advantage of the situation.
What a horrible bunch.
Most agreed, my lord. Though it doesn't change the fact that for now they're our allies. We should get whatever out of them we can to cut down our own casualties.
Yeah, like anybody on my side's dead, Eugen. Where have you been?
We needn't actually reward them, fuck 'em.
Eugen, I like the way you think, old man. These guys are probably... Hey, they actually have, skills. They would have mug. Oh god, I gotta stay away from these dudes. Or does it apply to me? I would imagine it would. Good attention to detail, though. Yeah, I kinda wanna fuck off, because Julius is probably gonna stick his spear right at my ass. Hold up, Neron has, 17 defense. He'd take 18 times 2. So he would live. He would most certainly live, but if I do that, then there's always the problem where... Yeah, I'm gonna let him go kill those guys. So one of you guys said that there was a way to easily cheese this map, and I'm guessing this is it, right? Because he's probably gonna fly off the throne here, I imagine. And then Rudy could easily seize.
This church also serves as an orphanage. We take care of children whose parents have been lost in the war. Prince Barker used to be our benefactor, so we've done fairly well until now. But after the Imperial Army retreated, the other citizens came and raided our coffers.
Assholes, man.
The children haven't had anything to eat since yesterday. Please save these poor souls.
I have no fruit!
I understand. We'll manage somehow.
Now I just feel bad. Somebody buy these kids something to eat, man. Somebody think of the children. Where's the store? I got this. Don't worry, I got you. I got you, lady. Or maybe it's a money thing, and I'm broke as always, so Oh, they don't even sell fruit. Well, bummer. It's probably a chrono trigger. Ah, yes, this one piece of jerky will provide ample rations for our entire army. Thank you so much! I never understood that. Never will. Don't question it, it's video game logic. So, over here... They're just ignoring Vega entirely, and that kind of makes Vega mad. He doesn't like being ignored, don't you know? So he's gonna blow this guy back. Eventually. Come on, Vega! You're better than this! You're better than this, man! I definitely want to see what he's gonna do before I do anything stupid. I might be able to kill him, actually. Right now. I might be able to kill him right now. If I bring him over to this side, anyways. Let's think about this. I don't think I can, actually. And even then, I think San dies. I think San just falls over. he'd have 35, she has 13 defense. Oh yeah, she would fall over immediately. Neron would not, but I don't think I can get him close enough to me. Similarly, Raphael actually tanks. No, he doesn't. No, he doesn't. Math is hard. Yoda tanks because he doesn't get doubled, though. I can try it. I'm gonna try it. But the thing is, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Actually, can Meriel even take one hit? No, she actually doesn't. So I'd have to canticle. Same with Maru, she doesn't take even a single hit. And she gets doubled, which is terrible. Not to mention, I forgot, he hasn't got a shield, so it doesn't matter. How am I killing this guy? Does 25, but... Definitely want to buff up my mages. Definitely wanted to buff up my mages before I tried to fight him. Also, I really can't let these guys be over here by themselves, because, like, they'll get messed up. They'll get messed up bad. Yeah, I think we're gonna stay the fuck out of his way for at least one more turn, and then we should be good to go. Or at least that's the plan. Samson's looking a little bit lonely over there, I'm not gonna lie. Oh, I forgot to visit one of the houses, didn't I? Maybe not, I actually can't remember at all. Alright, so Julius... I'm watching him like a hog, man. He's gonna do something that kills me. Oh, and he just heals up the general as well. Nope, I forgot to move Neron. That's bad.
No!
Prepare yourself, Reven. Let's see if you have what it takes.
I don't have what it takes, man. Leave me alone. I forfeit. What is this? Why is it lagging? Did he just crit me or something? No, it just decided to lag. Now he kills. Yeah, he's dead. Well then. Mom, I'm sorry. I can't ride home. Wow, that's sad. That's really sad. I have no idea why that happened. I mean, obviously restart as well. There's the Drago. I don't think I visited this house yet. No, I don't remember this.
The Imperial Army's got nothing on us. We're as good as the champions of Utona. Well, of course we are. We're fighting to free Reeve too. But now those champions are marching in and stealing all the credit from us. Oh yeah, fat chance, dude.
Really, do you even see Julius? Yeah, let me know how that goes.
With your 5 strength and your iron sword.
Let me know how that goes, bud.
The nerve of some people. Did you think it's for something up the Imperials?
Yeah, this voice is way more appropriate based on how they're sounding.
It's a damn shame. Anyway, that guy from last night barely put up any fight at all. We are so badass, man. No matter how many times I hit him, he just keeps crying for his mommy. I'm telling you, man, these Imperials are all a bunch of pussies. So what's that make your total now? I'm up to 4. I've only gotten 3 so far.
Vega's over here like, I got 3,000. 3,000. And they're just like shitting themselves.
I've only got 3 so far, but I didn't realize we were competing or I'd killed a few more.
Are you guys fucking serious?
What's up with the service here? Don't you people know we're saving your country here? Show us a little respect and bring out the booze.
Don't talk like you're some kind of heroes. You're just a couple of murderers. You're not fighting for anything. You're just preying on the weak. Don't you feel any regret at all? Something's wrong with you. Don't act like you can compare it at all to what the champions of Utona are doing. You're nothing.
What are you saying, man? Play cool, man. Some of those guys from the champions just showed up here. Let's not make a scene.
Yeah, that's what I thought, you little bitch. Know your fucking play. Yeah. Oh, talking all big and talking all this smack when we're not around. But say it to my face, you little bitch. Say it to my fucking face.
Yeah, I'll remember this.
He's like, oh, Sir Ernan. Nice to see you. Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay, so I sold some stuff and now I have enough money for this, apparently. Now, I could be an asshole. It's pretty tempting. I usually relish in the opportunity, but I think for today we will pay 3,000 gold.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. May the goddess bless each and every one of you.
Well, can't say I'm surprised. Can't say I'm surprised. I don't know what that did. Did that do anything? Well, at least I now truly understand the gift of giving. Alright, so hopefully this time he doesn't fly in and rock my face off. He shouldn't. I really don't think he should. But he might. Okay, so the guys on the right don't really want to attack for some reason, which is pretty annoying. It's really just Julius who matters, though. Everybody else is just kind of along for the ride, man. Oh, yep, there he goes to the left-hand side. I really wish he'd be way more aggressive towards my own units. I cannot believe that he actually got hit there. What the hell, Vega? You're letting me down, if I'm being perfectly honest. Never mind, he's so good. I can't believe he keeps getting defense. What's really annoying is that none of them are attacking him. That's really annoying, actually. There we go. Do, do, do. Not even the archers, though. It's, I don't understand. Is the AI really that good? Am I really this bad? Holy crap. Really? He's just gonna stay over here and slaughter them the whole time, isn't he? That's really annoying. Because that means he's gonna make me track his ass down, and I don't really want to do that. And he's gonna waste all my fucking... I was told that he drops this, so he's gonna waste this. Please use the slim sword, dude. He's not going to, though. Ugh. Raph doesn't actually survive. Maybe I can make this work. Doesn't really matter what I equip, he's going to get rocked. Now this looks crazy, but I did buy a shield that I can give him. And I will do that right now. And provided he doesn't get adepted or crits, what are the skills that he have again? Just for curiosity's sake, soul, Nile, adept, and charisma. So yeah, provided none of that happens, he should be alright. I don't know how useful this really is to me though, because I don't know that I can kill him in one round. This is probably the worst move of my life. Man, he's just gonna waste all my spear uses now.
Take this, you hyenas. Feel the wrath of Kanan.
Yeah, there goes two uses right there. Man! That's a shame. These guys are such chumps. They're ignoring Vega, man. Vega doesn't like being ignored. Yeah, see? That's what happens. That's what happens. That's what happens. Man. It looks like he's in a bad spot, but he's definitely not. I don't think the other two can even hurt him. The other three, rather, if I could count. Counting is not my specialty. Yeah. Shoot, Enta. See if I care. So lucky. So very lucky. I've never been this lucky in all my days. So the only thing I can hope to do is throw somebody in there that he could theoretically one round, who's one of my characters. And I guess that would be Meriel. I mean, this makes sense. In theory. The problem is that this is a terrible place to fight him from. Yeah, this is just not a good spot to fight him. It sucks. I guess. Oh, gotta move him out of range, obviously. But other than that, I guess we just hope for the best.
Please attack my guys and not the friggin' generics.
Either one would be fine. Actually, I lied. I don't think either one would be fine. I think it really has to literally be Meriel. In which case, I kind of messed up. Nothing I can do about that. Do I even care about these guys? I don't think even they can kill Maruj. Right? Maybe they can. I don't know. I think I would rather have Maruj. No, he gets destroyed. He gets utterly annihilated if he gets hit, so it's not even worth it to try. That's my logic, anyways. Alright, so please, attack Meriel. Because technically he can kill her, but he actually won't be able to because of the canticle blocking his second attack. Or we could really just fuck about and continue wasting my spear. Either or. Come on, you guys. Quit acting like you were really gonna do anything here to begin with. Okay, so what happens? Son of a bitch! Come on, dude! That's just annoying. That's not even fun. That's just annoying. Especially because I have to kill him. Seriously, that's not good. I don't like that at all. I like that. But I don't like this design at all. It's just frustrating and incredibly tedious. Why should I have to chase him down? And they continuously spawn too, so it's not even... Ugh, it's so dumb. That's poorly designed, I don't like it. That's really bad design. It'd be way faster to just restart and get his attention before he has a chance to go do this. Why would I even bother? I mean, really. Yeah, this is dumb. It's not worth my time to try and do this. I'm just gonna restart. Okay. Here goes nothing, man. Man, I cannot believe that. Now, I see what they were trying to do with having the mercenaries fight the soldiers, and it would be like this whole epic battle kind of thing, but the way it works out is just obnoxious, man. Alright, so hopefully she doesn't get adepted or crit or miss. There's a lot of things that can go wrong here, actually. Well, good thing I used the stave staff. Still not sure why this happens. There must be some kind of effect here that just totally messes up the emulator. Now, as long as I don't miss, we're at a good spot. Okay, now it's even lagging for a bit. That doesn't make any sense. I have no idea. I didn't change my settings or anything. Just God forbid I have a run that runs smoothly, I guess. Why is this happening? I don't get it. I don't get it at all. Yeah, move. We know. Not like it matters, he's gonna die this turn. Otherwise I lose. Like, if he doesn't die right here, I've lost already, so kind of irrelevant. Why do I keep letting this happen? I saved staffs, don't worry. Come on. Now she's gonna do the same thing again, but from like, I think this would be the best spot. No. This guy. The real threat, thank you. As long as I don't miss. Okay, so it's literally Julius causing the lag, I guess. Why? We've already fought Wyverns before, it doesn't make any sense. It really makes no sense at all. I guess it's as good as mine, guys. Maybe it's the back row? Shoot, man. Now it's gonna bother me. Let's see, I'll shoot with the Arbalest. I'm probably going to miss, but I might not. And if I don't, that would be great. That'd be just fantastic, even. I don't. Sweet. And Raquel can do the same thing. Nah, dang it. Gimme. Yeah. Oh, she doesn't actually hurt him, so never mind. Failing that, Naron should actually be able to injure him. But I am going to save staff right now because he could just kill me. Which is kind of bullshit. Yeah, I'm not going to sit around and risk an adept. There's no way. Honestly, Vega might be able to do it all by his lonesome. Not quite. But if I hit him, he still won't be able to. Bravesword is how powerful? Steelblade would do it, but... I mean, after Naron gets a hit, of course, it would do it, but the thing is, I'm still not very fast. Right, I can't crit him ever because of the Goddess Shield, of course. Yeah, so I'm just gonna have Naron chip him down. In theory. 56% of the time this works out. And it does. I forgot he heals from that shit. Oh god. I have fucked up. This, ladies and gents, is why we have the save staff. Shit, man. I think I just lose. There's one more thing I can try. Nope, not that. Down here. I already sold so much stuff this chapter, but like... Man, Julius is a bitch. Taking him down is not easy at all. I'm gonna sell that. I'll hold on to the Hero's Crest, because I still might be able to promote Leone. Just for the hell of it, I guess. And then I'm gonna buy two Miracle Charms. And then I'm going to Well, you'll see. This might not even work. This might be a complete waste of time. But if this doesn't work, I've already lost, basically. So it doesn't matter. I have to encircle on Marouge because he has 10 fucking magic. Then we will start trading these miracle charms. And eventually they're gonna end up on Marouge. You can probably see where I'm going with this, but Marouge gets cleanly one-shot by Julius. And I'm hoping that because the miracle charm breaks, I don't actually get damaged, so he can't heal. That's the theory. I also still need to hit, which I very easily could miss. Because I have terrible luck. But if this works, then I might be able to salvage this. We do hit. He has 5 hit points left, but Neron can actually deal 5 damage. Let's see right here. Blocked, no damage. Blocked, no damage. Yes. Okay. So that worked. He didn't heal at all. He's down to his last 5. And Neron can bring it home, I think. Alright. Let's see. 88%. Lag makes it... Oh, thank God. Yeah, you son of a bitch. Way to go, Neron. Bring it on home, boy.
Theodora, please protect my nephew.
And slowly fade out. Nope, it's Julius that caused the lag. I have no idea why that is. Whew. That guy was a monster. I'm not even going to lie to you. I'm not even going to lie to you all. That guy's an absolute savage. But he suffers the problem where there's one of him and there's about 15 of us. To be fair, though, only about 5 of my units could do anything to him. Oh my god. I liked what they were trying to do with this map, but I really think those gladiators should have just not been a part of this at all. And he should have just moved on his own. That would have been more than enough. Think about it. Why would it even make sense for him to go out to the gladiators when Runin is right at his doorstep? Why would he let Runin just walk right up to the throne and seize it? It doesn't make sense. I know it's not a seize map, yada yada yada, but in-universe, it doesn't make sense for him to leave the throne and not go after Runin himself. Makes no sense at all. And even then, when we start wandering into his range, he still goes after the small fry. Why? Why? They literally can't even hurt him, and he should know that. Enough bitching, I guess.
Hear me, soldiers of Kanan. Everyone is ready to retreat immediately. This is an order from Prince Julius.
Wah, wah.
Prince Julius, why?
Runin, fuck you, man!
Are you Lord Runin of Roselia? My name is Theodora. I am a Wyvern Knight of Kanan.
Be careful, Lord Runin. This woman is Julius's right hand. She might be concealing a blade.
She called herself a Knight of Kanan. At ease, Eugen. I don't believe she's here to fight. What is it you want from me, Theodora?
Please. Would you give me Prince Julius's body? I want to bring him back with my own hands and reunite him with his beloved in Kanan.
Or beloved Kanan, I guess.
I see. I have no problems with that. You may have his body. Please give him a proper burial.
You have my gratitude, Lord Runin. Now then, I beg my leave.
It's kind of weird. Just stop by Neron for no reason. I mean, he's alright, but he's kind of a weenie.
That woman. I think she was crying.
No shit, dude. Yes, I believe you're right.
Regardless, we mustn't let what happened spoil the occasion. We have achieved victory, my lord. Let us return to the royal palace with our heads held high.
I get what they were going for with this map, but I do have my problems with it. I think I've made them clear enough, though, so we can just continue with story, I suppose.
Lord Runin, a multitude of aristocrats from across Reeve are flocking here. What shall I tell them?
Aristocrats? Well, what do they want?
Nothing good, I'm sure. They're most likely just trying to get into your good graces, Lord Runin. Now that a Reeven is back in power, they're hoping you'll restore them to their old positions of authority. They're shamelessly self-serving.
Even if you're right, we can't afford not to see them at this point. Let them pass.
Yes, my lord.
Good day, Lord Runin. On behalf of the royal family, I wish to thank and congratulate you on liberating the palace. We are all in awe of your valor.
Count Tatus, I didn't think you were still alive.
I managed to escape the prying eyes of the Empire, and I hid myself in the castle town until today. These last 2 years have been difficult. How can you expect people like us to rule effectively if you soldiers won't do your job? You'd do wise not to let such a disgrace happen ever again, Lord Rudin. Want to say that to Vega's face?
I'll go fetch one of the servants, Lord Rudin. This room's going to need a good mopping now that this oily slug's gone and dragged his hideous self through here. Ooh, sick burn, Eugen.
You insolent bastard. I'll have you know you are speaking to a member of the royal family.
So what is it you want from me?
I like Rudin. Right to the point. I've come with news of great importance to all of Reeve. With the return of Princess Maeve, the kingdom of Reeve can finally be fully restored. Naturally, of course, I have asked Her Highness for her hand in marriage.
Oh, Rudin's not gonna like that.
As you have been here a protector for so long, I came here as a courtesy so that you could offer us your blessing. I mean, really, why would you choose anybody but me? Do you hear my voice? I am amazing. And I've got this nice purple tuxedo. This nice purple silk robe. Absolutely amazing.
Okay, is that so? What does Her Majesty think of this?
She has agreed to leave the matter to me.
Really?
You have no objections, I trust. Then please join us in the throne room.
Right. Enta's on crack. Enta's on drugs.
Lord Rudin, I present you to the heiress to the throne of the Kingdom of Reeve, Her Highness Princess Maeve. Your Highness, this is Lord Rudin, son of Duke Gravind of Roselia, and the one who liberated this royal castle from the clutches of the Zoa Empire. He has requested to be granted an audience with Your Highness.
Lord Rudin.
Why? Why is she doing this? Quit fucking about, Enta, come on.
Her Highness wishes to express her joy that you have remained so steadfastly loyal to the royal family of Reeve. As fiancé to Her Highness, I also wish to express my gratitude to you, and it is my sincere hope that you will continue to endeavor in your loyalty to us.
I'm afraid that won't be happening.
What? What did you say, Lord Rudin?
I can never swear loyalty to a man like you, Tatus.
How dare you? You don't approve of our engagement.
Of course not. I will never accept this.
Why, you insolent brats!
That's enough, Count Tatus. I understand your plight, Lord Rudin. But Count Tatus is the only surviving member of the branch families, and thus the only eligible candidate.
Enta, are you fucking serious? You've gotta be jerking me here. This cannot be happening. I mean, I understand she's mad, okay, we're having this little cat fight, whatever, man, but this is too far. This is too far, I will not stand for this.
If you will not espouse the kingship yourself, this is my only choice. The people of Reeve already wait for the day that you will become their king, Lord Rudin.
But Your Highness, this simply will not do. As I have said before, it would be unthinkable for a princess to marry someone as lowly as a mere nobleman with only a maternal connection to the royal family. If you ignore all precedent and make this boy king, our traditions will be lost.
Lord Rudin, when we first arrived here at the capital city, I realized just how little I knew about my own country.
The wealthy... When did she have time to do this, by the way? I'm just... At first, I almost thought this was going to be like an imposter, but no, this is definitely Enta. Quick change artist, man. She must have been hanging around Plum.
The wealthy have been greedy and self-absorbed without any sympathy for their fellow man. It is truly a pitiful sight. I realized that in order for our holy kingdom to survive, I would have to prune away the brambles that are choking its lifeblood, the common citizens. I knew that if you were with me, Lord Rudin, we could put an end to this aristocratic tyranny that is destroying our homeland and change this kingdom for the better.
What are you saying, Your Highness?
But alas, my selfish wishes are but a nuisance to you, aren't they, Lord Rudin? You would have nothing to do with me, are you? She's...
Come on, Enta, you cannot be serious.
Do as you will then, Lord Rudin. Once Nozeria is at peace, I'll return to my clerical duties at the Water Shrine. I only ask you this one thing. Please do not desert Reeve. I beg of you, Lord Rudin.
Are you serious? Women! She's joking, right? Like, come on now, where are the cameras? It's unbelievable. Extra patricide. Ooh. That could only be Barker then. Ooh, that sounded gory. Visceral.
Ugh. Barker, you.
Forgive me, Father. I will be with you soon.
You fool.
And here's Clara. Oh, that's who... Oh, okay. Maybe it is, maybe it isn't. I will have to see. But yeah, she's the one that took Zeke. Okay. The threads are coming together. Well, wasn't that a show? Lovely performance, I must say. Even for a traitor like you.
Carla!
Yes, it is. Okay. Did I say Clara? I meant Carla. I don't know why. Yeah, I was doing that before, and I noticed that I kept confusing Clarice. Or I didn't confuse the two. I knew they were separate people. But I kept saying Carla when I was referring to Clarice. I gotta break that habit. They're like... They couldn't be more different, actually.
So you were.
Here the whole time, yes. But I was certain Julius was going to be the one to kill the old man. It's all the same to me, though.
You. You were waiting for us to kill him.
Of course. He stopped being useful to me many months ago. And now the Kingdom of Canaan will finally come to its inevitable end. Arliss, consumed in the flames of the Dragon Musa. You, executed for murdering the Emperor. And Julius, who as we speak is destroying himself out of shame for his inaction. The three stars of Canaan fall and the son of Zoa rises. Praise be to His Excellency, our great Pontiff Gwen Chaos.
Shut your mouth, witch! I'll kill you where you stand!
As Empress of the Zoa Empire and consort to the late Emperor Bannock, I hereby sentence you to death, Barker of Canaan.
Ooh. We've seen that spell. Was that, is that the same one that Gwen cast? No, I don't think it was. Ah, it's failing me, it's failing me. I can't think of it.
God, no, I can't fall here!
I mean, technically he survived. Pathetic wretch. Oh, and here's Sine.
Stand back, Prince Sine. That's Empress Carla.
Carla? The witch who killed my mother.
Well, isn't this sweet? It really is the kid from all those years ago. Did you come here to avenge mommy, boy? Come and try me then. Give me your best shot.
Carla, I'll kill you!
Stop, Sine. You can't defeat Carla. She's under the protection of Gwen Chaos's magic.
Don't be a spoil sport, Temujin. Long time no see, by the way. You've certainly looked better.
Carla, you were such a sweet child. And now you're a murderer. A few gray hairs and wrinkles are nothing compared to what's happened to you. It's pitiful, really. This world is such a cruel place.
How dare you look down on me? You're a traitor, Temujin. You threw away your comrades for your own selfishness.
Better than abandoning my child and murdering my love for Gwen Chaos's sake. Or am I wrong, Carla? Now then, run along, girl. You and I both know you can't bring yourself to kill your old mentor.
I will take my leave for now. Enjoy what little time you have left, traitor. It doesn't matter if I kill you now or not. You will all be consumed by the black rain of Gurxel when he rises again.
Good God. This just got turned up to 11 real quick.
Ah, that man.
What's wrong, Stephanie?
No. Father?
Right.
Please hold on, Father.
Stephanie, why are you here?
I came in with Sine. But Father...
Sine? It's really you, isn't it?
Yes, Uncle Barker. It's me.
You're all grown up now. You look so very much like your father. You know, the guy I just killed in cold blood.
Please try not to speak. We'll get you to one of our clerics to tend your wounds.
No, it's too late. I'm beyond saving now.
Don't say that. You can't give up, Uncle.
Sine, I leave Canaan to you. The future that we dreamed of is within your grasp.
Father?
Uncle Barker, this is unforgivable.
Carla! Ooh, Sine's pissed!
I don't think he can do much, though. He was probably one of the weaker of his own unit. Not by, like, a long shot. He was actually... he was decent. He was definitely better than anybody I had by the time we actually saw him for the first time. Just what the fuck does Enda think she's doing, humiliating me like that? Can you believe this? Oh my gosh. Lord, stay my pimp hand. Jesus Christ, Rudin, chill.
Are you speaking of what happened at the Royal Palace with Count Tatus?
Yes, I am. It's true, I don't want to be king, but I never said I wanted nothing to do with her. And is marriage so trifling to her that she would settle for a man like Tatus? She is kind of slow, Rudin. I don't think she fully comprehends. What's going on in that girl's head? Is this her way of getting revenge after the argument we had?
Hardly, Lord Erden. I think this particular matter has caused Lady Enta much grief. As princess, she is but a figurehead, but as queen, she would have power to effect real change. While she could not fully make her feelings known with Tatus in the room, I think she was trying to reach out with you. Reach out to you. You must talk to her, my lord.
I want to, but I just can't find the words. Let me give you a hint. There's three of them. And it's about 10 letters total. 8 if I could count. You could do it, Rooted. Keep thinking about how harsh I was when we spoke back at Castle Roselia. I know she's still mad at me.
Lady Anta had truly a miserable upbringing, both as a prisoner and a princess. She sees all the corruption in the aristocracy,
there we go. Now all of a sudden I can't say it, crazy.
But she has no real say in how the country is run. You, however, being the firstborn son, have had an extremely privileged life. Your father groomed you luxuriously, and you wanted for nothing. I believe Lady Anta holds a grudge against you because you were not concerned with the kingdom's politics. Then again, what do I know?
Eugen is like low-key super smart. That's absurd, Eugen. I'll have you know that I bear the responsibility of becoming Duke of Roselia.
Not for long, my lord. After your terse words with Tatus today, you can bet that he'll strip you of your title once he becomes king.
That's a good point. Roselia is mine by birthright. He couldn't do that to me. He literally can. He's a king.
Yeah, I assure you, he could. Such is the authority of the king. And that's why you mustn't let that incompetent buffoon take the throne. Take the throne. King Badoon practically tore this country apart without the Empire's help in the 40 years he reigned. He's half the reason Reeve is in such a terrible shape today.
Not to mention his wanton persecution of the Zoans and the constant betrayal of the trust of other nations. It's no wonder Bondock turned on Reeve.
Precisely. And under a man like that, it's always the powerless, the common citizens who suffered the most. Lydia knows this all too well, so she has solicited you for help. To her, the word marriage is more than a simple ceremony of lovers. As king and queen, the two of you will support each other's strengths and...
That's enough, Eugen. I'm done talking about this. Ah, Rune is so indecisive. Oh, it's Verna. Hey, what up?
What up, girl?
Here to give me my final Pegasus Knight, I hope?
Lord Runin, pardon my intrusion.
Verna, did you bring news from Sine?
Yes, I've just come from Kanan. Prince Sine has taken the Kanan Hall and he has declared the end of the Empire. All of Kanan is rallying behind him. Now, since both Reeve and Kanan have been re-established, His Highness requests that the official peace negotiations be held as we agreed earlier.
Very well. Eugen, we're going to Nolzaria. Get the soldiers ready to depart.
Right away, my lord.
I'll come along as well.
Is that happening right now, or do I get a save point at least? Oh hey, dragons. Okay. This seems like an odd place to hold a peace treaty. Yes, the beautiful fields of Nolzaria, right behind that Draco zombie nest. Where there's ogres and bone walkers and harpies. Yeah, seems like a really good place, Rudin. Way to go, guys. A plus work there. How long has it been recording anyways? Yeah, you know, I think we'll keep it short and sweet. I'm not sure how long it's going to be by the time I finish editing everything, but it's been like an hour-ish. So, this last battle, I pretty much pointed out all my qualms with it just in the battle itself, but I really do like the idea they were going for, like I say, but it's just frustrating having Julius run around and attack those freaking soldier guys. And you know what? On second thought, that's probably what you guys meant by cheesing it, right? Because if he broke his weapon on the gladiators, then he would become basically a pussy. Well, not really. His stats would still be insane, but he would lose a lot of his bite. So I assume that's possibly what you guys meant, since you have to kill him either way. But that's what makes it so obnoxious to me. Since you have to kill him, the fact that he wastes all of his time on generic gladiator dudes just makes it a pain in the ass. I don't want to play a game of tag with the boss, okay? I would rather just be able to fight him. It's totally fine that he moves, it's totally fine that he's insanely powerful, although I could very easily see you putting yourself in a no-win situation if you're not strong enough to deal with him. Or at least throwing a lot of bodies at the guy, because, I mean, honestly... Yeah... He's really, really strong. There's no real way to put it other than that. He's incredibly strong. Incredibly powerful. His weapon is insane. You know, on second thought, I bet that's why the gladiators are there. I know I was bitching about it, and I don't change my stance on that at all. They could have done a better way of balancing this, if that was their concern, but I think that they were there in case you couldn't kill him, so that he would at least break his weapon. I guess that's the only thing that makes sense, but I don't like that at all. I don't like that at all. I still think that's really dumb. I digress. Enough bitching, eh? So next time we're gonna go off and sign this peace treaty that's apparently held at the Hill of 1,000 Monsters. But until then, thank you for watching. If you did enjoy this, feel free to leave a like, comment, do whatever you want to do. Anyways, guys, till next time, have a good one out there. Peace.